the hottest news, the latest updates. This is Push Daily.
Top 3 news of the day.
Marcelito Pomoy advances to semifinals round of America's Got Talent. Marcelito Pomoy advanced to the semifinal rounds of America's Got Talent, the champions, after earning the most number of votes from superfans or fans of the show from each of the 50 states of the United States. The Filipino singer drew a standing ovation from the judges and audience of the show as he performed the duet song The Prayer, singing both the male and the female parts. Judge Simon Cowell gave Marcelito a perfect score of 10. Judges Alessia Dixon and Heidi Klum also praised Pomoy's hair-raising performance. In a statement on Facebook, Marcelito said that he didn't expect to get into the semifinals round. Ngiting tagumpay. Sa totoo lang po, hindi ko inakala makakapasok pa ako sa semifinals. Lumipad kami papuntang US na ang dala ay panglimang araw na damit lang. Maraming salamat sa AGT Wardrobe na nag-provide ng outfit ko. May plane ticket na rin kami pa uwi kinabukasan ng audition, kaya sa isip ko siguro sign yun na hanggang audition lang ako. Marcelito went on. Maraming salamat sa aking may bahay na nagpalakas ng loob ko. Siya ang nagpilit sa akin na lumaban dahil natatakot po talaga ako kasi nga hindi ko kaya mag-English at hindi ko alam kung magugustuhan nila ang talento ko. Ipagdasal po natin lahat na makayanan ko pa ang sunod na laban, ang semifinals. Maraming salamat po. Luis Manzano hits back at bashers, calling him an opportunist for selling overpriced masks. TV host actor Luis Manzano did not back down from a basher who claimed that he was taking advantage of the current situation brought about by the Taal volcano eruption by allegedly overpricing a special type of face mask he's selling online. On Twitter Monday, Luis reposted a tweet from a netizen who questioned him for selling Cambridge masks to filter out nearly 100% of airborne particles such as those put by the Taal volcano in Batangas for 690 pesos. He then responded by posting screenshots of his supplier's price list from 15 weeks ago. These were our supplier's prices 15 weeks ago. So did we hoard ba? Nope. Nagtaas presyo ba? Nope. Did we take advantage of the situation? Nope, he said. Reposting another tweet from a different user, Luis wrote, Ate, 15 weeks ago yun na presyo ng N95 or N99 Cambridge masks. Yan presyo talaga globally. Tinaasan ba namin dahil sa pagsabog ng bulkan? Sinabihan ba namin na mainalay ba kami sa bulkan na pumutok para mabenta? Mas marami na po ata kayong abo kesa utak po. In the end, Luis wished for everyone to stay safe and alert as the situation could get worse anytime. But let's pray for the best. God bless the Batanggenyos and everyone affected. He said, Sandara Park sends love to Philippines amid Taal volcano eruption. Sandara Park sure hasn't forgotten her connection with the Filipino people as she sends some love to those affected by the Taal volcanic eruption in the Philippines all the way from South Korea. On Twitter, Sandara Park shared a photo taken during the eruption of the Taal volcano last Sunday, January 12. The 35-year-old South Korean star wrote, Please stay safe, everyone. Sandara Park, a former member of girl group 21, isn't the first K-pop idol to send love and prayers to the Philippines.
For more showbiz and updates, visit push.com.ph. Don't forget to like, follow, and subscribe our social media pages.